Hi everyone, my name is Stephen Poitras, Solutions Architect here at Nutanix, and today we're going to be talking about the Nutanix Disaster Recovery and Replication solution. So if we look at the traditional replication topologies, there's really three main replication topologies that are very commonplace. The first is a site-to-site, or S2S, which is essentially two peers which are replicating to each other, either one direction or bidirectionally. The second, which is probably one of the most common, is what we call a hub and spoke. And essentially what that is you have one central data center or central site which acts as the spoke, and then multiple branch or regional sites which replicate centrally to that spoke. This is probably one of the most frequently leveraged replication topologies out in the industry today. And last but not least is what we call a full mesh. And essentially what this is it's not a site to site, it's not a hub and spoke. Essentially you can replicate from any site to any site bidirectionally. So with this, you can replicate, say, if we call this site A, from site A to site B, C, and D. And the key thing with this is realistically, you're not going to replicate from one site to four sites, but it does give you the most flexibility in terms of your topology. And the key thing for Nutanix is we actually support any of these configurations. So you could have a combination between a mesh and a hub and spoke, or just use site to site. The other key thing to mention there from a replication perspective is all the Nutanix controller VMs within a cluster actually participate in the replication. So if you're replicating from a 32-node cluster to a 32-node cluster, you have 32 controller VMs replicating with 32 other controller VMs. So it's very efficient there in terms of the actual replication. The other key thing is where we actually do data protection and do the replication. So with Nutanix, we're purely VM-centric. So everything we do from a snapshot perspective, from a replication perspective, from a protection standpoint, is all done at the virtual machine level. And within this, there are two main constructs. The first one is of a protection domain. And essentially, a protection domain is a group of virtual machines or files. Most commonly, you'll see this referred to as a PD. Within a protection domain, you can have what's called consistency groups. And essentially, consistency groups are groups of virtual machines or applications which need to be snapshotted and replicated in a crash-consistent or application-consistent manner. And you'll see these referred to as CGs. Within a protection domain, you can have multiple consistency groups. So most commonly what you'll see is if you have a certain application or service, you'll actually have all those virtual machines that make up that application in a consistency group, and then you can have multiple of those within a single protection domain. One of the key things also is from a replication standpoint. So if we consider this to be site one over here, and these virtual machines to be part of site two, and I'm doing replication between these sites, we basically leverage the same framework and fingerprinting that we use for our deduplication. So if I have this virtual machine here that writes blocks A, B, and C, say, for example, this virtual machine at the target site has written blocks A and B. When I actually go to do the replication, what we'll do is we'll first query the remote site that we're replicating to, see which data he has or which fingerprints he has, compare that to what we're actually going to replicate, and only send the data, which in this case would be C, over to the target site for replication. This is extremely important when we start talking about replication bandwidth, because essentially we've just taken two-thirds of what we would previously had required and eliminated that down to only sending the data that doesn't exist there. So that covers Nutanix Disaster Recovery. Thanks for watching.